For more videos on people's struggles, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Hello, you're watching People's Dispatch. I'm Surangya and we're reporting from New Delhi, India, where a group of protesters have gathered to oppose US President Donald Trump's visit to India, chanting the slogan "Trump, go back." These protesters represent various organizations such as student organizations, women's organizations, trade unions, international solidarity groups, and all of them are here today because Trump's visit and his agenda to visit India represents a threat to the various sectors in India. So let's take a look at what's happening and talk to the protesters here to find out why they are here and why they are protesting.
The protest against the visit of American President Donald Trump. We are here to convey the opinion of Indian people who do not appreciate the visit of American President. American President Donald Trump is imposing the imperialist hegemony policies on the whole world. And now India has become target of American imperialist power. They are looking for a big market in India. They are trying to make India as a strategic partner in the Asia Pacific region. And this is going to be detrimental to the interests of the country. The American president's visit will not and should not take the country and make it subservient to American imperialist power. That is why we are protesting and opposing the visit.
Both of them share an inherent bias against women, against Muslims. They share Islamophobia and they are against migrants. So it is for these reasons that we are organizing protests throughout the country. And as per the information that we have now, protests were organized in Puducherry, Hyderabad, Kerala, and many cities in Kerala and Calcutta.
US President, go back!
Go back! Go back!
Go fascist government, down, down!
Down, 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 down!
Go fascist government, down, down!
Down, down, down!
By inviting Donald Trump to this country, our great Pradhana Mantri decided to attack millions of rural women on their livelihoods. We are all know poultry and dairy are major industries which are giving life, which are the main breadwinners among rural poor. Particularly the Trump, they are trying to influence our government to import dairy products and chicken legs from America. If this will happen, naturally our dairy industry and poultry industry will be affected very badly.
See, my feeling on India buying American equipment has been that ever since India started this strategic partnership dialogue with the US, with the Indo-nuclear deal on the one hand and the defense partnership on the other, my view has always been that the nuclear deal was not the primary target. The nuclear deal was the key with which to open the lock for the defense partnership, because the US was not entering into defense partnerships with India because of India's nuclear position. So if that got normalized, then the defense partnership gets opened up and then America would get access to India's lucrative defense. And we have seen now that over the past decade, India has bought more than $10 billion worth of American military with another $7 billion in different stages. So about $17 billion of purchases were made. As far as Make in India is concerned, these military purchases have all been for high value armaments, but which are in small numbers.
So if you see the current visit, there is a discussion for 24 helicopters and 8 additional Apache attack helicopters. If you buy equipment in these small numbers, there is no scope for indigenization, manufacture in India. None of those things can happen. It will always be outright purchase. But to my mind, the more important aspect is not just that India is buying defense equipment from the US, but the US is dragging India closer and closer into its strategic orbit, whose main purpose in this part of the world is to encircle China. And India has fallen into that trap of the US, which is going to impinge on India's strategic autonomy and freedom to take its own national security decision based on national interests. To my mind, that's going to be the biggest compromise going down the road, because whether it's Trump or not Trump, this is a trap that India is going to find it very difficult now to get out of.
We also reject the deal of the century proposed by Donald Trump against Palestine. Also, we reject all his attempts to do world global policy in different countries in the world. We also express our solidarity with the people who are struggling in Palestine. We also express our solidarity with the people who are resisting the restrictions and embargo put by US and the Cuban people and different sections across the globe.
Encantado.